It's your boy Jimmy Blue, Mr. All Access Elite Boxer, reporting live from Dallas, Texas. I'm here with Hector Finito Tanahara. How you doing, sir?
I'm doing good, bro. How you?
I'm doing well, man. Thank you for asking. Listen, brother, it's fight week. We're here in Texas. We're here in your home state. From San Antonio all the way I-35 up here to Dallas, man. You're here on the, you know, headlining with Virgil Ortiz Jr. and your stablemate Joshua Franco. I know you guys are like brothers. How are you feeling, man? It's fight week, brother.
I feel good. It's one of the best feelings I felt in a long time. I haven't felt this good. My weight's good. I still have a lot of energy. So, man, I trained good this camp, and I feel ready to fight on Saturday.
Listen, brother, you know, this is your third time fighting here in Dallas?
Yes, third time.
And, you know, you're undefeated. You're 17-0, man. What goes through your mindset, brother, you know, leading up days up to a big fight like this?
I just try to stay relaxed. I know every fight is different, but I just stay composed and everything because I know my training went so well and I trained so hard that I'm going to get the W no matter what.
Yeah, I know definitely as a fighter, man, you got to expect the unexpected. You know, you're relatively young, man. You're 21 years old, I believe.
22.
22 years old, apologies. You're 17-0, man. But now you're getting up there, you know, close to 20 fights, man. Mm-hmm. Pretty soon, you know, you're moving up the rankings, but pretty soon you're going to start getting tougher and tougher competition. Mm-hmm. When you see the Teofimos of the world, the Ryan Garcias of the world, are those fights that you eventually are going to ask for?
Oh, yeah, it's definitely. I'm ready for them whenever. But, yeah, like you said, eventually they're going to come. I'm ready for them. I'm going to ask for them. But since I've known those guys since amateurs too, so I've always had in my head that I'm going to fight them guys one day. So, yeah, I'm ready for whenever that's going to happen.
Listen, let me ask you, man. As a fighter, you always want to continuously keep improving and improving, man. Is there anything particular in this training camp that you worked on?
Just my inside game a little more. Just getting all aspects instead of in case the guy wants to get in there and be on the inside too. So I'm ready for whatever. I was sparring some good tough guys, so my inside game is something I've been working on and just being a little bit more aggressive.
Definitely, man. It's all about being versatile, especially in the sport of boxing. But you training at RGBA, man, you have all different types of looks. I mean, you've sparred guys like Eric De Leon, Mikey Garcia, Lindulfo, you know, and the list goes on, man. How important is it for you to remain in that type of atmosphere, being with Robert Garcia?
Oh, it's great. You know, one of the best atmospheres ever. Like you said, I get different looks, so one day I could be boxing, or one day I'm going to have to be in there in the inside, you know, different looks, just in case, you know, how the fight goes. You never know how a fight could play out, anything could happen. But being there, you know, you always stay ready for anything.
Let me ask you, man. I ask this to every fighter. You know, walking out to the ring, Hector, do you ever feel nervous, man? Do you ever feel, you know, that those butterflies in your stomach?
No, I'm already used to it and comfortable already, so I just feel ready, try to get my mind right. So I don't get nervous at all. I just get
anxious.
Anxious, yeah. Just get my mind right and focus on the fight more than anything.
Well, listen, man. Do you know anything about your opponent this Saturday?
I know he's tough. He's gone the distance with some hard hitters, so I know he could take a punch, and I know he's tough. So I'm expecting a tough fight, but I'm gonna use my distance, my ring IQ, and be real explosive in there and being aggressive at the same time.
Listen, man, we appreciate your time, Hector. Is there any last shout-outs you want to give to any of your friends, family, or even sponsors?
Yeah, no, shout-out to all my sponsors, Los Altos, JD Collision, everyone that's helped me out for this camp, all my friends and family back home, San Antonio, 210, you know, everybody here in Dallas. Thanks for the support. Shout-out to my boy, you know, FedEx, rest in peace, and George at rest in peace too.
Well, listen, man, we appreciate your time, Hector. El Finito Tanahara, it's your boy Jimmy Blue, All Access Elite Boxing.